Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome once again to the Baptist Bread Devotional and Scripture Song Broadcast for this 20th day of March, and it is Sunday, and today's topic for the Baptist Bread is titled, The Character of the Crucified Man. And before we get started and all that, I'd like to greet you as always in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Amen. And he too can be your Lord and Savior if he's not already. And if you are saved, we'll hope and pray that this broadcast will be a help and a blessing to you in these devotionals. Amen. That's why I read them and to get them out there so you can we can be better Christians and take heed of these messages. Amen. So praise the Lord. All right, we're going to start with today's scripture song from Proverbs 20, verse 1. So press play and sing along with Brother Dean and Sister Patty. Amen.
Proverbs 20, verse 1.
Wine is a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. Right. Wine is a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. Wine is a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. That's right, so make sure you stay away from strong drink, and you can go in anywhere in the Bible and read all about what happens to people when they drink, and that strong drink gets in them, and all the things they do that are wicked. So you can take heed to that and use that as an example all through the Bible. Amen. All right, so we'll do that again towards the end of the broadcast, along with yesterday's. And now it's time to get into today's topic, the character of the crucified man. And this is from March 20th, Sunday, and it says here in Romans 6:11, likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so you are made alive through Jesus Christ when you trust him as your Lord and Savior, and you're dead indeed to sin. So make sure that we stay dead to sin and the old man. Amen. And then 1 Corinthians 15:31 says, I die daily. So, amen. So let me read you the whole entire passage there of that, because we need some context here. So 1 Corinthians 15:31, and I encourage you to go back and read the whole chapter. Amen. But we don't have time to really go over all the whole chapter, but I'll read you 15:31. All right. So 1 Corinthians 15:31, and it says here, all right, so 31, it says, all right, where can we go back here? All right, so let's go back here to, well, I don't really know where to start here, but I'll read you the full passage of chapter 15:31. It says, I protest by your rejoicing, which I have in Christ Jesus our Lord, I die daily. If after the manner of men I have fought with beasts at Ephesus, what advantage it me if the dead rise not? Let us eat and drink, for tomorrow we die. But be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt the good manners. Awake to righteousness, and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame. But some man will say, how are the dead raised up, and with what body do they come? Thou fool, that which thou sowest is not quickened except it die, and that which thou sowest not that body that shall be, but bear gain. It may chance of wheat, or of some other gain. But God giveth it a body as it had pleased him, and to every seed his own body. All flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds. There are also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial, But the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another, and so on and so forth. So I encourage you to read that whole entire chapter, because it talks about the gospel, amen, but didn't want to get too far in there, but we got to remember that we die daily to the flesh, that is, amen. All right, so let's get into the topic, the character of the crucified man, and this is by DC, that would be the initials for Dennis Corley, and he's an evangelist from Claysburg, PA, and he writes here, he says, "This isn't possible physically, but it is essential spiritually. This old carnal nature has to be reckoned dead every day, and some days many times, right? There are certain things that will help me to know whether or not this is a reality in my life. It's not some mystical thing that is beyond my ability to know. I can know whether or not I have the marks of the crucified life, whether or not my character would indicate that I'm practicing my God-given position as a child of God. So often, when we talk about the crucified life, it's just something that sounds good, and I hope I'm doing it. But how can I know? In Matthew 20:20-23, the mother of James and John came to Jesus requesting a position for them. In response to the request, Jesus asked this question, 'Are ye able to drink of the cup that I shall drink of, and to be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?' They say unto him, 'We are able.' And he saith unto them, 'Ye shall drink indeed of my cup.' You ask, 'What baptism is that?' In Romans 6:4, it's the baptism of death. Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death. That baptism is a baptism of death. According to 1 Corinthians 12:12-13, every believer has experienced this baptism at salvation, but every believer has not yet reckoned it so and practiced his or her position." So, being dead to the flesh and crucifying the old man and being crucified with Christ, amen. All right, so let's read 1 Corinthians 12:12-13. Go there. So 1 Corinthians 12. All right, so 12:12-13. All right, so let's see here. It says, "For as the body is one and hath many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body, so also is Christ. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we are be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit." And then 14 says, "For the body is not one member, but many." And then so on and so forth. So, amen. I encourage you to go read that whole chapter also. Amen. So, let's make sure we take heed to this character of the crucified man and how we're supposed to live for Christ and let the Holy Spirit rule and reign and have control of us, all of us, and not give in to the old man, the old nature. Amen. All right, so that is the end of the Baptist bread. So let's take heed to how we're living and living the crucified life. And as it says, "I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me." Amen. Praise the Lord. All right, so now it's time to get into the Boots on the Ground devotional. And this is from the book Boots on the Ground, Daily Devotions for the Christian Soldier by Randy Wells. And today is the 20th. And the topic for today is titled, A Prayer for Peace. And this event takes place on March 20th, 1797. And it says in Jeremiah 8:11, "For they have healed the hurt of the daughter of my people slightly, saying, Peace, peace, when there is no peace." Jeremiah 8:11. All right, he writes here, "As governor of Massachusetts, Samuel Adams proclaimed a day of fasting on 20 March 1797. In his address, Adams stated, 'And as it is our duty to extend our wishes to the happiness of the great family of man, I conceive that we cannot better express ourselves than by humbly supplicating the supreme ruler of the world that the rod of tyrants may be broken to pieces, and the oppressed may be made free again, that wars may cease in all the earth, and that the confusions that are and have been among nations may be overruled by promoting and speedily bringing on that holy and happy period when the kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ may be everywhere established, and all people everywhere willingly bow to the scepter of him who is Prince of Peace. Amen. And he writes here, continuing on, someone once said, warfare is the engine that turns the wheel of history. Since man has been on the earth, wars and rumors of wars have continued to frustrate the hope for peace. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Right? Matthew 24:6. Samuel Adams understood that peace will only come when the Prince of Peace is ruling this earth. Right? When Jesus comes back to rule and reign. Amen? Until true world peace does exist during the millennial reign of Jesus Christ, it would be expedient for state and federal representatives to lay aside political rhetoric and beseech the only one who can truly bring peace to our world. Right? Amen? Because Satan is still the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Ephesians 2:2. So, got to make sure we understand that Satan is still the god of this world, and Jesus doesn't rule and reign yet. Amen. So when you say Jesus is in control and all that stuff, he's not in control yet. Is he even in control of your life or my life? We should ask that question first before we start saying, well, God's in control. If God was in control, there wouldn't be murder and babies being aborted and people being killed and wars and all this other stuff if Jesus was totally in control of this world. But he's not. He will be one day, but make sure that when you're saying God is in control, that you watch what you're saying, because he's not. And is he really in control of your life or my life? We should ask that question first. Is he in control of me before you say he's in control of everything that's going on around you, which he's not. Satan's the god of this world, so he rules and reigns right now. But one day, Jesus will rule and reign, so you might get upset with me by saying that, but you know it's the truth that God is really not in control. He's in control of what he's doing, but he's not in control of what man's doing. Man does what he does because he's sinful, amen? And so, but you can have God rule and reign and control you if you desire to have him do so, but a lot of times we just give into the flesh and just do whatever we want, even being saved. So, ouch. So let's take heed of all that, amen? All right, so continuing on. He says, world peace is not possible. However, peace for the individual or within a nation is possible if that nation will humbly acknowledge and pray for the peace of God as Samuel Adams did in 1797. Amen. So, again, let's make sure that when we're saying stuff like God is in control, well, you know he's not really in control. He might be in control of some things, but he's not in control of everything, because, again, Satan is the god of this world, and one day Jesus will be in control of everything. Amen. When that happens, so the first thing you need to do is let him be in control of your life. Amen. And surrender your life fully to him. And just as guilty that we don't always surrender everything to Jesus. Amen. We should, but we don't always. All right, so enough about that. Very convicting stuff there. So put that aside. And now go ahead and sing today's hymn. And pick this one. All right, so put that there. And I found this one here. It's titled, No, Not One, or There's Not a Friend Like the Lowly Jesus. And this is The Faithfulness of Christ, a spiritual song. And this is on page 127 in the Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs book. And this was written by Johnson Oatman, Jr., who lived from 1856 to 1922. And then George C. Hugg, who lived from 1848 to 1907. And so it says, we're singing this slowly and fervently. Amen. All right. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else can heal all our souls' diseases. No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. No friend like him is so high and holy. No, not one. No, not one. And yet no friend is so meek and lowly. No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. There's not an hour that he is not near us. No, not one. No, not one. No night so dark but his love can cheer us. No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. Did ever saint find this friend forsake him? No, not one. No, not one. Or sinner find that he would not take him? No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. Was there a gift like the Savior given? No, not one. No, not one. Will he refuse us a home in heaven? No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. Amen. And you know, I might have sang this not too long ago, but singing it again, amen. Nothing wrong with singing it again, so praise the Lord. But if I did sing this not long ago, sang it again, amen. So praise the Lord. All right, so I'll give you the story here at the bottom, in case if you missed the broadcast that this might have been on last time, I will tell you the story again. All right, it says, the works of both lyricist and composer are numbered in the thousands, each prolifically inscribed gospel songs for use in service to the master. Composer George Hugg served as a choir master and authored more than 2,000 harmonies. Lyricist Johnson Oatman, Jr. labored as a full-time businessman and penned in excess of 5,000 songs. Amen. So I'm pretty sure I did sing this one not too long ago, but amen. So it's hard to remember which ones I've done already and which ones I haven't. So again, if you have one that I haven't done yet, let me know and I will sing it for you. Amen. All right, so maybe next time I'll do this one. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus. And in the book, there's 8 stanzas here, so perhaps I'll do that one tomorrow. Amen. And that's 135 in the book here. Let me give you the references really quick for this hymn, No, Not One. And we got Zechariah 9:9 for stanza 1, and then 1 Peter 2:24, and then Hebrews 7:26, and Matthew 11:29, and then Proverbs 18:24, and John 16:33, and then Hebrews 13:5, and John 6:37, and then the final stanza, stanza 5, is 2 Corinthians 9:15 and Titus 1:2. And then the refrain, we have Hebrews 4:15 and Hebrews 13:5. Amen. All right, so there you have it again. No, not one, or there's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. Amen. All right, so I'll put that aside, and we'll sing some scripture songs before we wrap it up. And so let me grab the scripture song book, and we'll do yesterday's, and then conclude with today's. All right. Let's play there.
1 Timothy 3:16.
And without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world, received up into glory. Amen. Here we go. Without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness, godliness, godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world, received up into glory, received up into glory, received up into glory. Amen. All right, now we'll sing today's, and we'll...
Proverbs 20, verse 1.
End it after that.
Wine is a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise.
That's right. Wine is a mocker, a mocker, a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. Wine is a mocker, a mocker, a mocker. Strong drink is raging. And whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. That's right, amen. All right. Well, that'll be it for today's broadcast. But before I go, let me give you tomorrow's scripture song and then the topics for the Baptist Bread and Boots on the Ground devotionals. All right, so tomorrow's the 21st, and we're singing Psalms 5, verse 3. It says, my voice shalt thou hear in the morning, O Lord. In the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee, and will look up. And that's good advice that we should pray first thing in the morning when we get up, before we do anything else, and pray and spend time with the Lord in the morning, and spend some extra time, get up a little earlier in the morning, and not be so rushing around, and spend some time with Him by getting in the Bible and praying and looking up to the Lord. Amen. All right, so that's tomorrow's scripture song. And then tomorrow's topic for the Baptist Bread is titled His Disciple. And the passage is Luke 14:33. So that'll be tomorrow's Baptist Bread. And then tomorrow's Boots on the Ground devotional will be titled Symbol versus Idol. And this event takes place on March 21st, way back in the year 630. And this passage is from 2 Kings 18:4 is the passage. So we'll learn more about this topic, symbol versus idol. Amen. All right, so that's the boots on the ground. And then perhaps I'll do the hymn, Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus tomorrow. So amen. I don't think I've done that one yet. All right, so if you'd like to get a copy of the Scripture Songs book and CDs, they're available on Brother Dean and Sister Patty's website at www.dailyscripturesongs.com. And that's their website, and they're missionaries to Port Kaituma, Guyana. So you can go read their latest prayer letter and find out what's going on with them and everything that's happening there in Guyana over there. Amen. So praise the Lord. And then also, like I mentioned yesterday, pray for Becky Norton, Brother Mick Norton's daughter. His one daughter there that had an accident with some machinery when she was helping him at the construction site that he works at. So pray for her and healing and all that stuff. And so, amen. And if you don't know the Seminole String Band, I recommend you go check out their music. And that can be found on mine at YouTube. You can go listen to their music on YouTube, or can't remember the name of their website, but I'm sure if you type in Seminole String Band, it'll bring it up. Amen. And that's the Norton family. So praise the Lord for them. All right. And so if you want to get a copy of the Baptist Bread, this is the cover for this month and next month, and it's got a donkey on the front of it. And the address for that is www.baptistbread.com. And then the Boots on the Ground devotional is the cover here, and that's found on the internet or perhaps at your local bookstore. And then the book here, Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs, is found on melodypublications.com. And I just saw an advertisement that they are offering 10% off of their hymnals right now. So if you go there, and I think it's if you type in Spring 2022 or something like that, you can get 10% off of their hymnals. So I highly recommend getting one of these, copies of one of these, whatever color you want. There's three different colors, so amen. And that's the cover right there. Very thick book, lots of hymnals in it. Amen. So praise the Lord for that. All right. And if you'd like to listen to audiobooks being read to you, I've been doing some of those. I did The Hiding Place and then Return to the Hiding Place, and now working through the book God's Smuggler about Brother Andrew and his story, and going into the Iron Curtain and distributing gospel tracts and Bibles and stuff over there way back when. So check that out. It's God's Smuggler. You can listen to that being read right now. So I'm on chapter 9, I think, 8 or 9 right now. So check that out on God's Messenger Lighthouse podcast, amen, on Anchor or Spotify or iHeartRadio. All right, well, that'll be it for today. So thanks for watching, and may the Lord richly bless you until next time. Remember, Jesus saves, so believe on him if you have not trusted him already. And amen. All right, see y'all next time.